Out to Pleasure takes us to the South Pacific, to rushing torrents and gentle rivers, to the home of the big trout. Why is fishing the perfect pleasure? Ask old Isaac Walton, the father and patron of fishing the world over. 300 years ago, that complete angler described the thrill of making the fly move on the top of the water as if alive, of outwitting the subtle and fearful trout, and enjoying a dish of him for supper. But better than the sport or the supper, Walton loved to view the silvery streams gliding silently toward their center, the tempestuous sea, yet sometimes opposed by rugged stones and roots, which broke their waves and turned them into foam. How pleasantly the meadow looks, and the earth smells sweetly too. The harmless lambs, the beasts, the birds, the cheerful sun. These and other sights possess his soul with great content. This is Louis Bromfield speaking. It's a far cry in time and space from Walton's Eden to New Zealand's paradise. But both are real places, and anglers come from all over the world to visit these tiny communities and their neighbors. For the incomparable lakes and rivers of New Zealand's South Island are filled with trout and salmon big enough to stagger even old Walton. Here, for instance, is Lake Manapouri, fed by its great rivers, the Waiau and the Spey. And here the experts and learners congregate to fish and to learn to fish. They bring their tackle with them and meet with the easy comradeship of fishermen the world over. A reel, can you cast a line, then you choose a lure. This girl from the States hasn't been here before, and she's new to it all, but he'll help her, for she has joined the Isaac Walton Fellowship. The simplest way for a beginner is to troll a lure. Then you wait until something happens. Something does, and fast. How big is it? 2 pounds? 3 pounds? Maybe 5. Anyway, it's a nice size for her first fish. And what a paradise. No fishing rights, no restrictions. These lovely waters are free and open to all the world. Air and water sparkle like champagne, and so does the girl. But keen as she is, she's new to the sport. The rhythm of her casting breaks. The big fish and the experts are not impressed. Let's try it again. You must get back the rhythm, for rhythm is the secret of success. and forth. Back and forth. Easy does it. Now our beginner is gaining confidence. She is not yet an expert, but she is a quick learner. Rainbow trout on a 5-ounce rod. That's worth all the effort and the learning. But 50 feet away, her teacher shows how the experts do it. Now that's fishing. But there are other things to learn as well about these fish, which court and mate and breed. Here is the final phase before the birth. The female is guarded by her mate, who drives away intruders, while she herself waits and waits and waits for that supreme moment, the miracle of birth. The hundreds of eggs are necessary if the species is to survive, for they are preyed upon by countless enemies. But heart and brain and gut are active in the egg, to feed, to grow, to change into a fish, if nature wills it to survive. Above the water, the mood is peace, but beneath the surface, there is no peace, only constant struggle and the fight for survival. It's amusing enough to watch, but to the fish, the fun is deadly. For this is a water jungle where life goes to the wary, the quick, and the cunning. And a quick death is all the loser can hope for. And so, the cycle of nature completes itself. Only one living creature attempts to break it, man. And even he feels small and helpless enough up here, set against the mountains and the fjords of the high country. And what a country! Incomparable alike in its sounds and in its silence. This is the home of the large brown trout, a creature so beautiful that, as old Isaac Walton says, the very shape and the enamel color of him has joyed me to look on him. But before you catch him, you've got to find him. And when you do find him, don't scare him. Remember, he is the subtle and the fearful trout, aware in his own extraordinary way of all that goes on above the water, as are indeed all wild creatures. There is always a real contest of wits between man and fish. Therein lies the charm of fishing. It is a true sport, not mere slaughter for slaughter's sake. These two are moving so quietly because they understand the trout's point of view. They know that to him the surface of the stream is a mirror. He sees reflections in it, but he doesn't see much through it. So the anglers keep under cover and take care not to cast shadows. They know also that the trout doesn't so much hear a sound as feel a vibration. And so there must be no quick movement, no broken twig, no dislodged pebble to scare him. For all these things are danger signals to the trout. Any one of them sends him scurrying to cover. Now here's a royal fish. He'll be a problem, for he's all of 15 pounds. And the rod is only 6 ounces, with a leader whose breaking strain is 5 pounds. Good trying to force this fish in. He hasn't grown this big without knowing how to take care of himself, as quite a few anglers could testify. He's hooked, but he's not caught yet. He's a monster. He's in finest fighting trim. And the water's fast. If ever there were a lesson to be learned, it is now, for the tackle, light to give good sport, can take no sudden strain. Down there by the bluff is his chosen battleground. He knows that the hidden rocks will help him. One of those jagged lumps can break the finest gear. The rod must take the strain and help to tire the fish. River and rock are both on the south side. And against the angler. The ground is against the angler, too. It's hard to keep a footing, and down below, the water is fast and deep. this, the odds are all with the gallant fish. For he is gallant, and the girl knows it. Weary as he is, he still fights furiously, shaking his head to break the leader or wrench the hook from his jaw. He gasps with exhaustion, and again the girl feels a pang of admiration and sympathy for him. Yes, real sympathy. The fish has done all he can. He's tired out and can only gasp and twist as the man winds up the reel to net him. His battle and his life end here. And yet, he is a fish, and fishing is a gallant sport. So let him have his sporting chance. Let him live to fight another day. Many an angler has felt as this girl does, and has done the same thing. For, as old Isaac Walton told a pupil long ago, the trout is not lost. For pray take notice, no man can lose what he never had.